As a marina owner, operator, or manager, you run a business. You maintain a community gathering point, and you're the keeper of the waterfront. And the way you run your business can help keep our waters clean and healthy. But if you want to do more to protect our waters, where do you even start?
The Clean Marina Program is a one-stop shop. They have all the practices that we need to preserve or to make the marina fit into the environments written down in one place.
You go to those that have already done it and try to make it as easy as possible, because again, the end result is we want everybody to come on board and teach all of their boaters to be environmentally sensitive.
It's very important to us, but I think it's also important to the community. It's letting the people know that we're willing to put forth that extra effort to make sure that we're doing it right.
Clean Marina programs are voluntary, common sense programs of best practices any marina can adopt that go above and beyond existing laws and regulations. Sometimes they're pretty simple things, like hanging a recycle here sign or marking storm drains to let people know they drain directly into a river or lake. In this video, you'll see a sampling of some of the Clean Marina Program's best management practices you should consider for your own marina.
This is our manual that we developed in-house for the Clean Marina Program.
He was thinking he might actually.
Every year we would go over this with all of our employees, and this is a log that shows that we reviewed our Clean Marina Program with all of our employees signing on.
One Clean Marina best practice is all about waste management, keeping marinas free of garbage, and at the same time, promoting recycling. But waste management is a team effort. Marinas and boaters both need to do their part to keep trash out of the water and off the land.
Our boaters are a lot more educated today than they used to be. They're really looking at ways that they can conserve and protect their environment also.
Since even sailboats have engines, marinas have to deal with waste oil and used oil filters. Belle Mar Harbor in Michigan has turned that problem into an opportunity to reduce waste and costs and bring in a little revenue.
So what's this gizmo here? What we have is we've got an oil filter crushing machine. It compacts the size of the oil filter so that we can get more of them out in a smaller drum, and gets the extra oil that's in there out so that we can dispose of that properly.
Can I see it work?
Run pneumatically. Any oil that's in there runs down, we collect in the bucket, and then we put it into our containers over here, and we actually sell that oil that is reused.
So now, that's a switch. You used to have to pay to dispose of that, right?
Yes, we used to have a company come in, and they charged us to take the oil away. So we went out and got a bigger drum, and now they pay us to take it away.
All right, that's great. It's amazing how much oil comes out of those filters.
Yeah, it does help. Otherwise, it's in those drums, and wherever they're taking it, the oil's going with it.
And does that lower your hauling cost to get the?
Yes, it does, because they do it by barrel. So if I've got 10 in there or 100 of them, it's the same cost.
Another best management practice concerns stormwater runoff.
We have a parking lot here. We have grass, we have sidewalk, we have gravel, we have water. So tell me what each of these kind of layers are doing. Starting
Absolutely.
Over here.
So starting in the parking lot, you're going to have vehicles, boats, all kinds of equipment. The pavement acts as what we call an impervious surface. So it allows the water to run off that surface. It doesn't soak in the pollutants. So when you have something such as the grass here, that grass acts as a buffer. It helps to absorb the pollutants and any toxins that may be on that pavement before it hits the water. And so that is an excellent best management practice for marinas to have.
Well, we see just in this little bit of rain we're getting that the water is pooling, and you can almost imagine that it's picking up some of those pollutants as it runs off of that. Now, how about this gravel? Does that serve the same purpose as a strip of grass or indigenous
sure.
plant?
Concrete and asphalt are impervious surfaces. They have stormwater runoff. Grass and gravel are pervious surfaces. They allow the water to seep through, they soak up the nutrients, soak up the pollutants, and then they allow just water to flow through into our water bodies.
A lot of options too. You can do wood chips, you can do indigenous species of plants.
Absolutely. Yep. Those are all great best practices.
All seems like easy stuff to do too.
Yep.
We already talked about oil and filter disposal as a part of waste management. But because boats use a lot of oil and gas, many of the Clean Marina BMPs target petroleum control because we want to keep as many petroleum products out of our waters as we can.
When I fuel up my car, it has that little cone around it.
Right, exactly.
And here you got something else on that.
What we have here are our fueling donuts. These are designed to catch any fuel that would burp up out of the tank.
Is that some sort of specifically petroleum absorbing material?
Correct.
These hoses are really long. Is that part of it too?
At a normal gas pump, you only need to reach your car. Here, you need to reach down to dock.
Okay.
And problem with a long hose is you get chafing. They get dragged on the ground going over the dock onto the boat. So it's important that we keep an eye on those to make sure that there is no seepage. The other thing that we do, different than when you're fueling your car, is removing the fuel flow stops. So you're not able to lock the lever open and let it flow while it's unattended. As a matter of fact, you see the gentleman back there?
And it doesn't flow unless he's holding it.
It won't flow unless he's holding it. And that stops accidental spills, the nozzle coming out of the fuel filler.
And there's some things that are kind of surprising too. You were telling me that this being a no-wake zone also helps prevent chafing. How's that?
If you had a lot of high-speed traffic, the boats would be rocking back and forth, and you'd have the hoses taking all that abuse. And with the boats coming down, it really aids in the ability to help control spills.
Sure, and fewer spills just from the nozzle coming out, too.
Absolutely. And a lot of our training with our employees is important. We train all of our employees to use best practices as they remove nozzles from the customer. We try to carry them in an upright position to avoid any spillage that way as well.
What if you do get the occasional spill, then what?
We have numerous fuel spill containment systems, and they're pretty simple. Some absorbent pads. These pads work the same way as the donuts. They won't absorb water. Then we have booms, and what these are designed to do is if we do have a spill, they link together, and you're able to encircle the boat and contain the spill while we clean it up.
And I notice you have these throughout your fueling area.
We do.
All right, so Brian, what's the final piece of the puzzle?
The final piece of the puzzle is boater education and informing our boaters of best practices. We do that a lot through signage, like we have here, through our newsletters, and just through talking to our boaters in general.
So if people understand the procedures and why you're doing them, do you get a lot of buy-in?
Absolutely. And that's the biggest part, is just making sure they understand why and what it means to the whole boating community.
Following BMPs and becoming a certified clean marina can lead to increased sales of slips. And marinas can charge a little bit more for those slips too. Reduced waste disposal costs, reduced maintenance costs, and let's not forget peace of mind. And what you saw today was just a small sample of BMPs that can help you keep our waters and environment clean, create a pleasing atmosphere for your boaters, reduce waste, and help you save and maybe even make a little money. To learn more about BMPs, you can visit the Clean Marina Classroom at glcleanmarina.org. You'll find a list of BMPs dealing with boat maintenance, sewage handling, marina management, boater education, preventing the spread of aquatic invasive species, sample BMP checklists, and everything you need to know about becoming a certified clean marina. And best of all, you can take the course at your own pace. Thanks for joining us. We hope you'll consider being a part of the effort to keep our waters clean and our businesses strong. If you'd like to learn more about how to become a certified clean marina, visit www.glcleanmarina.org.